Media has been very rightly described by Malcolm X, who said, "The media is the most powerful entity on earth. It has the power to make the innocent guilty and to make the guilty innocent. And that's power because they control the minds of the masses." Good afternoon, everybody. I, Pankhuri Saxena, a student of class 10, present my views for the topic, "The media has become very powerful." The power of the media has been known ever since the struggle for the independence of India began. The newspapers constantly criticized the wrong policies of the British government, which in turn aroused nationalist feelings among the Indians. The British government soon understood what the press could do, and hence they introduced the Vernacular Press Act in 1878 to curb its rising power. But media is not only about newspapers. In fact, the news which we watch on the television comprises of a major part of the media. We are all very well acquainted with the fact that electronic media is very powerful. It can spread the news to all parts of the country in minutes. And electronic media plays an important role in a democratic country like ours. They make all the people aware of the political views of the various political parties by telecasting their election manifestos. They have even mobilized public opinion. The media virtually holds the power to make or unmake the laws. Holding innumerable debates with distinguished people, they shape public opinion, they spread their views, and they mobilize the opinion of the representatives who actually frame the laws. It has thus rightly been called the fourth estate by a statesman. They have enabled the exchange of political views of many ministers, politicians, and journalists. And thus, it can rightly be designated the title, "The People's Parliament Always in Session." We have often seen it in the past that the media has exposed the corrupt practices of the ministers on its own. And the power of the media has definitely overcome the power of the minister. We have had an outstanding example of what the media could do in the recent past. Maggie was found to have a very harmful ingredient, lead, in large quantities. The media influenced the thoughts of the government, and as a result, Maggie was banned. After several tests, when it was reintroduced, the support of the media led it to become the most selling noodles in 2015. Thus, we can say that the media has the power to shatter a company to pieces or make it the most powerful. In totality, I believe that the media has become a power to be reckoned with. With the advent of social media and subsequent development of platforms like Facebook, Twitter, WhatsApp, a whole new dimension has been added to the arena of media. People choose to express themselves on via these platforms and shape public opinion. In the words of Mark Twain, the famous author, "Only two forces can carry lights to all corners of the globe, the sun in heavens and the Associated Press down here. Here I rest my case. Thank you."